Now you see, we have this disillusion that when you get to America as Nigerians, that you just mix with the blacks, that they just accept you like that. That's not true. African Americans, they don't like us at all. Because everywhere in America, you know, every Nigerian in America, wherever we go, we have this safe American slang that we speak until the African accent comes out. So everywhere we go, say, what's up, man? How you doing, man? Yeah, what's up? How you doing? Until the black say, oh, yo, where you from, man? Now in America, where actually where you from? You say the state you're from. Yo, I'm from LA, man. Shut up, fool. Where you originally from? I'm like, okay, from Lagos, Nigeria. Now you're talking. I said, I told what? No, we ain't one. Our forefathers came here in shackles on chains. Nigga, you came here on a plane, fly, man. We ain't one, nigga. I'm like, okay, I didn't know it's that bad. Now, you would think it would be better with the white people. Those ones have a different opinion of us. Once they hear, where you from?
Yeah, I'm from Africa, man.
Where in Africa?
Nigeria.
Oh my God, have you eaten? You must be very hungry. Stacy, can you give him some food? So everywhere we go, there is just this wrong impression about us. But let me tell you something that will make everybody proud. In America, Nigerians are the most educated ethnic group in North America, Nigerians. And let me tell you, as a Nigerian, when you get into that community, you want to be part of that community. And as I stand before you, I am proud to let you know that as of this last summer, I can beat my chest to say I also went to Harvard Law School. For my cousin's graduation. But I went there. The fact remains that, you know, I went there, and to the grace of God, I can, you know, it's on record. And you see, in America, they respect us a lot. Now, let me tell you, there are signs that we are at the end of time. And one of them is this same-sex marriage that was legalized in America. Ever since they did that, you would think that for those of us who are normal, life would be better for us. It's not so. Because once they legalize same-sex marriage, even regular guys, we don't trust ourselves anymore. Gone are those days where you will call me, say, where are you? I'm at home. Can I come and meet you? Only you. Say yes. Don't worry, I'm all right by myself. Or now in churches, in America, they tell you, turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I love you with the love of the Lord. Neighbor, I love yourself, don't worry, love yourself. It's even gotten that bad. In America now, in mosques, it is the Muslim brother that are pity most. Because when they are praying, they don't trust themselves anymore. Because you know the way Muslims pray. You have to cover your bum bum. We don't trust ourselves anymore. It is going to the stage where some places in America, when you're walking and something falls from your pocket, you don't just bend down to pick it anymore. You have to pick it with style. And you walk backward. Or in some places where you know that you don't trust the guys, when something falls from your pocket, you just keep picking it until you get to a safe place. That I will not bend my bum right here. Or until you get to this place, you pick your thing and you leave. That is what is going on right now. And let me tell you something. Anybody that is in Nigeria, that is married in America, and is beating his chest, that is in charge of his house, is a big liar. We are all glorified plate washers. We wash plates to the glory of God. And you know there are some things you do in America that you can't tell your parents. So when you are doing it and your mother comes, every time my mother comes, she's always hearing water and plates and forks. She says, why is there always plates? I say, it's the television. What about your wife? I say, she's busy in the kitchen washing my plate. She say, go carry your mommy. Like, I say, little do you know that I'm a glorified houseboy in this America. The only place where your wife will slap you, bah! And you say, honey, that's the best slap I've ever received. Do it again. So why you say all this brother stuff? It's a big lie. Now, for my brothers in the East, Igbos are the only one that will be in America 30 years. Their accent will not change. See an Igbo man that's been in America 30 years, ask him, how long have you been here? Oh, 30 years. So, since you've been here, that means you've been influenced by American music. Oh, it's a good man. So what are your favorite songs and who are your favorite artists? Oh, Snoop Doggy Doggy. Dr. Andre. Boys 11 Men. Nah, I love those boys, they can sing very well. Ladies and gentlemen, give yourself a big round of applause.